if people had been apathetic, we couldn't have done this. It would have been too large of a job. Our goal all along was never to recreate the Tivoli, because that was a movie house, and it had a lot of blacks and golds and silver. That was not our goal. Our goal was to recreate a theater of the 1926 era. We started back in 2008, when we removed all the old seats, of which there were three different types in the theater, when we took them out. And we went ahead and we put in a style of seat with the end row that we thought would make be appropriate for a 1926 theater. We could tell from the holes in the floor that they originally had a slight arc to them. So we went back to that, because the seats that were in there were all in straight lines. And so by having that very slight arc, every seat in the house is facing stage center. So, and that was very apropos to the 1920s. The four large chandeliers that are in the theater, every single one of those chandeliers had cracked. So we found a craftsman, a local craftsman here in Frederick that was able to match the stained glass. Right now they're all fixed, so it's a mixture of new glass and old glass, but you can't tell the difference. And then the next phase, in 2011, we went from the street, we made it all the way to the balcony. And then because of schedule and everything, we had to stop there. And then we finished it in the summer of 2012 with the painting of the interior of the theater space itself. That took just about 2 months. And I think at the height of it, they probably had about 10 different workers who were doing the different stages. The scaffolding was an amazing thing to see, because recreating the whole floor above the chairs, and then having, I call them the Trojan horses, where they would go up another three stories so they could get up to the top, and they would roll those giant platforms along the other platform. It was ingenious. I really thought it was an amazing thing to do and to watch happen. The designs that you see throughout the theater, the decorative painting, were done by Nancy Pascal. She was our lead designer, as well as working with Sam Robinson of Valley Craftsman. Those are the two people who presented the ideas, the plans, the color schemes, and then we all worked together with a committee that was headed by Carrie Delant. So that between the committee and those two folks, we had a plan from start to finish. We have changed the look of the building without really doing any structural changes. We've just kind of reversed the color scheme, so we actually go from light to dark. And so it lifts the building up. I'm just astonished and grateful for the support that I've gotten from the community, the support I've gotten from the city. I'm fortunate that we have a great board of directors. We have some very progressive leaders on that board, and people who are willing to take chances. This was a project that was privately funded. I mean, the board of directors spearheaded a capital campaign. Oshman Family Foundation stepped up and gave us $200,000 in a matching grant, which was a great way. I love the way they do those matching grants, because then we can go to somebody else and say, you know what? For every dollar you give us, it's actually worth two. And people like that. PNC Foundation stepped up and gave us a large donation. And then lots of people stepped up and gave donations anywhere from $1 to $10,000. I mean, it was just, it was great to see the community do that. And it was great to see the board of directors do that in arguably the toughest economic times we've had since the Great Depression. But it worked. They finished it 9 months early, and you can see the results.